Sugarshack Sessions, yeah. What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of the Sugarshack Podcast. My name is Bryce, and we are here at Reggae Rise Up in St. Petersburg, Florida. How's everybody feeling? Come on, crowd.
Yeah.
Look at all of you beautiful people out there. It's great weather, great people. You look great. You sound great. And we're sitting here with Dry Reef out of Philly.
Yeah.
What's up, dudes?
Hey, what's good?
What's going on?
Getting sunburnt.
Yeah, it's nice. Sunburn, you get roasted out of here.
Yeah. Got the sunscreen.
It was snowing when we left Philly, so this is nice. It's a nice
change of pace. Yeah. It does not snow here. It's just hot and less hot. It's sweating, and you maybe don't sweat one day.
The breeze today is a lifesaver.
It is. It is clutch. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great session that you guys just played. First time being on our channel.
Thank you.
First time being on the stage. How do you guys feel it went?
Felt really good.
It was great. Yeah.
I had a blast, and I love the stage is so nice. It's so calming. The whole thing is calming. It's great.
Nice. This is good. Our stage is calming.
You guys feel about it? Yeah?
Nice. Yeah, did you guys like the session? Did you like the Dry Reef set? It's really cool. I love your sound. It's a very unique sound, so I want to talk about it. Like, tell me about your influences as a band and, you know, the brainchild of Dry Reef to mix these kind of genres together and stuff.
So we definitely started just loving Bob Marley, Sublime, and all that stuff. And me and Colin would learn all those songs and play them for our friends. And eventually, you know, we went to college and started looking at other stuff, other music. And, you know, eventually it just became this. But I mean, we've listened to everything from what? Tom Petty to Explosions in the Sky.
Metallica.
It just kind of happened.
Yeah. No, that's dope. But you guys execute it really well, though. It's really tasty, and it's really cool. And you had some friends showing up to show some love and support. Little Stranger, they're homies of yours.
Yeah, way back.
Tell me about that. Tell me about how you guys met and how you know each other.
I know John from way back, probably like age 14, something like that. I actually knew his older sister, Chloe, and then we met through just like music and stuff and jammed one time or whatever. And then met like years later, and we were like, whoa, what's up? It's cool.
We actually met, me and Colin and Charles used to go to his previous band shows, Long Miles, and we would just fanboy him, and eventually he let us be his friend.
That's awesome. Yeah. He's a cool enough guy that if you wear him down long enough, he'd be like, all right, we can be friends.
Yeah, they took us on the road, I guess, what, 2 years ago? That was a great time, and we just always keep in touch and hang. Slept on their couches and just a tight little family here.
Hell yeah. And you guys are going to be playing a show with them soon, right? Like you're doing a Philly show together or something like that?
Yeah, that's up in Philly because they're Philly, living in Charleston, but Philly natives. But we're playing Brooklyn Bowl with them up in Philly, which is a super dope
It'll
new venue.
Fun. Yeah, it's going to be a good one.
Awesome.
I think that's April 7th.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys have such a cool sound. So like kind of jam band, like how do you write? Like it just kind of flows out of you because of what all you've put in over the years?
Dude, it's hard. You got to find something you're excited about.
Yeah.
And that's the biggest part. Once you're excited about whatever you got, it's easy. Mm-hmm. Me and Charles spent a lot of time writing. Colin writes a lot of instrumentals. And the way Joey drums, he's like a songwriter. He drums like...
I don't know what I'm doing. I make it all up.
Like, how long have you been playing as a band together?
10 years.
10 years, yes. Joey joined in 2016.
Dry Reef's been a band for 10 years?
Yeah, we went to high school together.
So the three of us, me, Chuck, and Pat, went to, shout out, Upper Dublin High School.
Right outside of Philly already. Like,
I know,
you know, just new to this scene for me, and like not knowing you, I'm like, I don't know these new guys.
Oh, yeah.
You know, but you guys have been just local in Philly for a long time?
Yeah.
I've known Charles since fourth grade lacrosse.
Hell
and
yeah.
And Colin gave me...
What position did you play in lacrosse?
Close D.
Nice.
And he means that. Close he means D. Business.
And Colin, before I even knew Colin... He gave me a guitar lesson at my friend's house when we were in like fifth grade. He was just already sick at guitar in fifth grade.
Hell yeah.
And so it's been a long time, man.
Yeah. I hopped on board a little bit later, actually. Our band manager, Mark Franzen, I was in a band with him, and he reached out to me one day, and he was like, yo, these guys need a drummer. Do you want to fill in for them for a show? And And we did, and
we did one. I never left. These guys in the band.
Awesome. I never left. They're my best friends. They're my friends.
Yeah, we did one rehearsal, and he had never heard the song, and he just played it perfectly, and we had no notes, and that was the first second he sat on the drums, and we were like, "Wow,
that's awesome." Yeah, yeah, I mean, you guys have a great feel, and like, you just really tight together as a band.
Well, thank you,
like,
man.
Really impressive. We see a lot of music. You personally spoke to me, and so anytime that happens, I'm like, all right, I got to give these boys some love.
Appreciate that, man. Yeah.
So thank you guys for an incredible set. You got music that you're putting out. Like, what's kind of happening right now in your release world?
Do you want to take it?
Yeah. Right before we hit the road this past weekend, we were in the studio in Philly. We did two long days in there, but we got basically half of our album tracked, so we're gonna go another session once we get back, and an album later this year
coming soon.
Sick. We got to get you guys to the Shack.
Yes. I love that.
Where's that for me to spread
it out?
Further
south, right?
It is. So you got to like kind of route whenever you know it makes sense in your routing or whatever.
We'll be there.
Would be sick.
That'd be awesome.
We'll talk after. We'll make it happen.
That's great. Yeah,
anything else that you guys want to share or plug or let people know about or anything like that?
Just thank you all for being here.
Yeah,
stick
appreciate
around for
it.
Our set. This really means a lot.
It wouldn't work without you.
Yeah, we've been doing this a while, and sometimes you have wins and sometimes you have losses, but this is a big, big win. Thanks
beautiful
to you.
Place, yeah.
Absolutely.
So thank you all.
And also, Sugarshack, man, you guys are great. Crew's great. Everyone's friendly. Yes, smooth. Guys. Smooth operation.
Hell yeah. Come on, shout out to Sugarshack.
Give it a warm time for the Sugarshack.
Hell yeah. And on that note, that's a wrap on this episode of the Sugar Shack Podcast with Dry Reef and friends here at Reggae Rise Up in St. Pete, Florida. We love y'all. That's a wrap on this episode. Come on, boys.
Thank y'all.
Yes.
Thank you, man.
Stay, man.
Thanks, dog.
Hell yeah. Close to you.